can step down here. More stuff to look at. Mayor's imager requests. I guess the stars are either completed or important. Entry Canyon, Farley's House, Center of Town, Tree, Water Source, Waterfall, Membrane, Wall, Cell, question marks, the Wall slash Tower, Locomotive Power Generator, and Scrapyard slash Garage. Ambassador Seed, Swap Machine Functionality. Radius of Swap Sphere is defined at first swap. Immutable. Seeds recharge naturally from ubiquitous ambient membrane power radiation tied to tree health. Forcing seed open triggers prep behavior. Radius demarcation. I really don't know what this stuff, what this means. Small battery added to amplify ambient membrane power. Charges continuously. Parabolic focusing of power used to trigger seed swap behavior. Locking location or swap machines assures predictability, no unanticipated damage. Radius demarcation also occurs at same location in destination sphere. Without a pair seed defining the destination swap location, the destination coordinates match the source. Voila, swapping on demand. Alright, alrighty then. A book. Can I open that? Is that a book or like a frame or something? If it's, I can only, I can't, okay. Oh! Okay. I guess I double-clicked. Mofeng Solid Volume Projector. It's a good thing I'm recording this for posterity. Dimensional projector produces apparently solid apparitions with light volume and some sort of simulated mass. Ruko says all projectors will have similar power levels and communications protocols. There appear to be three primary elements. Projector element, beam emission, provides the primary light energy source. Control arms, some kind of control of the beam in three dimensions, color variable and mass invariable. Communications arms, internal comm signals supplied across gap to projection arms. So we got ohms gap here and some measurements, I guess. We'll use 7 volt communications level as a carrier voltage. Varying the voltage around that baseline voltage produces solid-like volume boxes in various colors formed from bottom to top, left to right. The Mofeng have tuned the retrace timing to 30 hertz for us. Mighty kind of them. If these are the people in the town that wrote this, I guess the Mofeng helped them in some way at some point. For full 3D resolution, or maybe this is something that they inadvertently did. I don't know. The Mofeng inadvertently tuned the retrace timing to an easier setting. I don't know. For full 3D resolution, or approximately 525 by 150 by 150, the converter would be required to adjust the voltage about every 3 nanoseconds? NS? I don't have an abundance of circuitry to build converters running at 333 megahertz, or for still projections rocks, the refresh doesn't matter. The display is persistent until unless the voltage varies from 7 volts. I can produce the projection from a still image and set the voltage to 7 to maintain it. Less than 0.8 volts results in clear, open, massless display space. Can I take a picture of this? Yes. Now, if only I could find out how to access these pictures in the game, I would do so. Image bounds. We got radio transmitter, speaker, converter, video source. Oh, these are these things that we see. Notes. Sound will be handled separately. Some projection noise, slight shimmer from radio interference, moving image corruption noise toward bottom of projection. Images above projection arm bounds are possible. Checking for potential hidden lethality. Mayor suggestion. Checks out. Can't find anything destructive. Consistent, spurious, very high frequency background carrier. No idea what that could be. Odd side effect. Projection intersecting any part of cell wall suppresses all transport. With an asterisk, saying, not sure why I try this. Farley claims it's related to some desire of mine to shoot everything and everything else. And that's it. Cool. So if I can find out how to access these, this could be helpful. I'm trying to figure crap out. I don't have to come all the way back here. Now this... I do want to look at this stuff too. I mean, for all I know, these are just screenshots of things that I look at them outside of the game. Still, it could be helpful. I can't access that little one. Oh, yeah, yeah. The vault. Address backwards. Okay, so we've got a mallet of some kind. Ish, ish. Is this one they're working on? Oh, they're projecting an image of a rock. So those rocks we saw the red go through, are those fake? Can I hit this with a hammer? No. If I can pick up the hammer... Nope, it just puts it back. Alright. And over here. Did it again. Well, they're working. These are spare ones. Maybe not. Well, I'm glad we got in here. We came from here, right? There's nothing down here to look at. This leads out. We can also close this. Let's keep it open in case I turn power off somehow. It probably can't happen, but just thinking, you know, from within the world. Okay, so we've got this contraption. Whatever the hell. Huh. So it looks like the cover to a grill. What can I do with you? Oh, there's another. Battery capacitor log. Crossed out. It says reverse something. Polarity. Hello? New plug. 16609. Work begins on battery. 89. Power test. No focal panels. 92. First charging implemented. 22. 10% charged. Just because I want to see 6167 over and over. So 10% charge, 22, same focal test, 2 equal panels, 29, efficiency changes implemented. 16822 measured 19% absorption maximum. 31, 50% charged. 16879, bleeder completed. 16 something. New secure plug critter proof. 16920, 100% charged. Same. Bleeder switched on. 932, topped off charge. 49, 6 focal panels built. Topped off charge, for a whole bunch of dates here. 41, all focal panels built, topped off charge, etc. Now I can also mess with this. Oh. Okay. Not sure what I did there. I can no longer... Okay. Yes, I can. Keep doing it. Sorry, guys. I'm supposed to plug that into something? So, I'm thinking this helps get the power back on? Maybe? Then I'm wondering if at some point we're going to find some kind of rail car or something that can travel on these tracks. Wom, 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 wom. Oops. Excuse me. Okay, wow. Okay, I'm supposed to mess with something else first, aren't I? Can I travel on this? No. I suppose I can walk across this. No. Oh, it stayed on. I need to hold it longer or something. I wonder what that did. It goes over the edge there. Down there. Alright. I'll go follow the lead down. Ish. I'm going in circles. I need to go, yeah, down here. There's so much up here, I forgot how I got down. Huh. So the tower... over the... Oh. I never realized I can climb up here. What did I? It goes up over there. Oh! We're on top of the roof. For some reason. I suppose I can go on this roof. What was that? I heard something creak. Oh, it's another thing we can look at. Oh, the tree! Is it where the tree is? That location on the map?
This is the tree. It has been here in Hunrath for as long as anyone can remember. Its health is intimately tied to everything in our little greenhouse.
Really?
Cell we live in, our ecosystem. It has provided many surprises over the years, including some interesting seeds
surprises.
That we'll learn more about. Many have postulated, yet we really know very little about its origins. But we do know it should be cherished and protected.
Well, certainly interesting. We're gonna go next to there. Or through there. It might meet up. I don't know. I can see it flashing from the other side, damn it. I was right. It does go across, or through. So what's this? Wondering if I can get up there somehow. Oh, that's where the tracks break off. Otherwise, we could get up there. Whoops. Let's see if I can open any of these doors. Looking for another button here. Is that part of the battening down process? They block things with rocks? I could open that suitcase or that dresser cabinet. Now, supposedly this place has power now. So I've been wanting to get back here. What's it say again? CW to Carolina, whoever else might come back. He's, or she has retreated to the vault. CW. And Caroline. Let me look. Margaret. Daniel. I wonder if any of these people are... Buried now. Benjamin. This one's been like... like they couldn't carve it, or it covers up another... this one's blank. Or covers up another name, either one. Carl Hunrath. John Farley and Robert Hartnell. John Hartnell. Mary Hartnell. Lothar Roscoe. Edith. Or Ida, rather. And we've tried to go in there, that's blocked by that force field. So let's try to go in here. Community center. I heard a noise. Alright. It's not that it doesn't have power. That's a dead end where I crashed. I guess that's locked. I'm wondering how I was supposed to be turning those. Turn one. One that had a track by it anyway. Right, so... and we tried this, right? This was locked. So if I could get to the other side, I'm kind of curious if I'd have any reason to. There is something over there. A painting? It looks like someone was sitting there and painting. Oops. Stuck on the rocks. Let me look at this map. CW. The sphere. Tunnels. Farley has power, but it's locked. Wait. What's her... what's her house number? We need that for a code, don't we? So that's her house number backwards. Farley. Okay. I'm writing this down. 1436. Farley house number. 1436. So obviously, whenever we come across anything that requires a code, it's going to be 6341. Okay, so what do we have out here? Besides that thing, which I have to go around the mountain, I guess. Might be able to get to it from here? No. Steps of some kind here. Oops. Look at that. It's rock here. I mean, we couldn't get through it anyway, but... So I wonder what this place is. Please don't tell me in the comments. So we can go up here. Which doesn't lead really anywhere. Oops. Okay. The code goes there, right? For her house. Okay, it crashed again. Right over here. Oh, it's coming out of here. Oops. So what's down this way? Found a way over there. Oh, this is where we were. Wait. Now this is not it. I can see the track. Huh. We can't get there from here. Crashed again. I'm not sure how often this saves, but seems to be pretty often. Maybe what's crashing it is it's saving. But stay tuned for next episode when I hopefully will get in here by entering the code 6341. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and always seek adventure.